Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amuls Academy. And today in this tutorial we are discussing about the shallow copy. In the previous tutorial we saw how to use assignment operator for the immutable objects. So today we'll see how to use shallow copy on the mutable objects. So shallow copy is a copying method. It creates a new object which stores the reference of the original elements. Okay, so when I'll do shallow copy, it will create a new object, okay, and which stores the reference of the original elements. So this definition may be little trickier, but when we take example, you'll get the clear picture, okay. So in the shallow copy, first we'll take the example, okay. Next, I'll explain you how it actually works, okay. When we learn this, we can understand shallow copy easily. Okay, fine. So first we'll take the example. We can do shallow copy in four different ways. Okay, so the first is we can use built-in functions. For list, we can use list. For set, we can use set. For dict, we can use dict. Okay, for dictionaries. So this is the one way to do the shallow copy. And the second way is we can use slicing operator. And the third way is using list comprehension method. And the last way is using copy function from copy module. So we can do shallow copy in four different ways. So we'll take example for each. Okay, so first we'll begin with the built-in function. So here I'll take the example of list. Okay. So next I'll take list2 equal to list. This function will create a new list. Okay. So here I'll take list1. Okay. So now if I check list2, now we have the two set of this data, right? So list1 and list2 contain same data. So now I'll modify one list. Okay. So I'll append a new value to list2. Okay. So now I'll check list 2. Okay, it contains 1, 2, 3, 4 and a new value. Now I'll check list 1. This change is not affected this list. So this is the first way to do the shallow copy. Okay, next we'll take the next example. Next we'll see how to do shallow copy using slicing operator. So here I'll take list 2. Okay, so list 2, now we have two set of same data. List 1 and list 2 contain same data. Now I'll modify list 2. So here I'll change the value present in the 0th index of list 2. I'll change it to a string. Okay, so now if I check list 2, we can see the value present in the 0th index is this string. Okay, so now I'll check list 1. Here we can see the different list. Okay, so this is the second way to do the shallow copy in Python. So third way is using list comprehension method. So for list comprehension, I'll take list 2. So here you can take any variable name. I'll take x. Okay, so now if I check list 2, here we can see same set of values. If I do any changes to list 2, so I'll change the last value. Okay, fine. So here the original data is safe and the copied list will contain modified data. Okay, so this is the third way to do the shallow copy in Python. And the last way is, for this we need to use copy module. So I need to import copy module. So next, I need to take the copy. This is the module name dot copy. This is the function name. And here I need to mention list 1. Okay. So now if I check list 2, It contains 1, 2, 3, 4. So now, if I do any changes to list 2, I'll append a new value. Hello string. So if I check list 2, here we can see a new string is appended. If I check list 1, it contains the original values. Okay, so these are the 4 ways to do the shallow copy in Python. So now we saw the example, but still now we didn't understand how this shallow copy will work. So I'll explain that now. Okay, so when I create a list, okay, this will be created. Okay, name is list 1. It contains 4 elements. Okay, this will contain the reference to value 1. This will be the reference to value 2. That's nothing but it contains the address of this value here. Okay, so when I do the shallow copy, so for example list 2 equal to copy dot copy list 1. Okay, so what will happen is, as definition says, shallow copy creates a new object. Okay, so here we'll get new object. Okay, so this name will be list 2. Okay, and this ID of list 1 and list 2 are different. If the ID of list 1 is 001, okay, then ID of list 2 will be different. So I'll take 002. Okay, so this also contains 4 elements. But here what it will do is, shallow copy won't copy the object, it will copy the reference. Okay, so here whatever the reference will be present here, okay, that will be copied here. Okay, so that is nothing but this also contains the reference to this object, same object. Okay, like this. Okay, so this 1, 2, 3, 4 values are shared between list 1 and list 2. So if you have still confusion, I'll take like this. Okay, so these are the values, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. This contains one address. Okay, so for example, I'll take 01, 02, 03 and 04. Okay, I'm taking this address randomly. Okay, so now this list 1 will contain that reference. Okay, here it will contain like this. So in the Python, list won't contain the values, it contains the reference to that value. Here we can see. Okay, when I do shallow copy, so it will create a new object, right? So this ID will be different, but it will copy the reference of that object. That's nothing but here this also contains same reference. Here both this list are sharing same contents. Okay, this is also referring the same values. So when I do any changes to list 2, for example, if I append a new value 10, okay, so here a new value will be created and that reference will be stored here in the list 2. If this is 05, okay, that will be stored here. Okay, this modification is done after the copy, that's why it won't affect the list 1. That's why we'll get two different lists. In this way, shallow copy will work. Okay, so now you may ask, if I take immutable objects, then I can use assignment operator, which will do the work. For the mutable object, I can take shallow copy. Okay, it will work. So then what is the use of deep copy? But deep copy is also important, because this shallow copy will behave differently for the compound object. For example, if I take the nested list, this shallow copy behaves differently. So I'll show you an example. So first of all, I'll show you this ID of list 1 and list 2 in the shallow copy. Print false, because list 1 and list 2 are different objects here. Okay, shallow copy creates a new object. That's why list 1 and list 2 are different object. That's why their IDs are not matching. Okay, so now if I take nested list and if I apply shallow copy, then what will happen? Okay, so here I'll take a list called list one. It contains nested list. This is the nested list and these are the values. Okay, so now if I use okay, so now if I check list 2, okay, this contains the same set of values. But if I do any changes here, so first I'll append a new value. Okay, if I check list 2, a new value is appended. List 1 is unaltered. But when I do changes to this nested list part, okay, it will affect the both the list. So I'll show you that. So if I take list 2, 0 and 1, okay, so here I'm referring this value because this is the 0th index and this is the first index. So equal to, I'll change this value to A. Okay, so now if I check list 2, okay, here we can see this value is changed. That's fine. But I'll check list 1 now. Here we can see this value is also changed. Okay, here we don't want this. Here we can see if I change a value in the list 2, it is affecting list 1 also in the nested list part, right? Okay, so this shallow copy behaves differently when it is applied on the nested list. So I'll explain you why. So when I take list 1 as, here this is the 0th index, this is the first index, this is the second index, okay? So here, this is the list 1, it contains 3 elements, okay? So here, this contains the reference of this list, okay? It contains 2 elements and this contains the reference to 1, this contains the reference to 2, okay? This contains the reference of 3 and this contains the reference of 4, okay? Okay, so I'll take this as 0001, okay? I'll take this address as 001, 002, 003, okay? That will be stored here, 001, 002, 003. Okay, if I take 01 and 02 this, so that will be stored here, 01, 02, okay? So now when I do shallow copy here, that is copy.copy of list 1, what will happen is it will create a new list, okay? So that will be list 2 and this also contains 3 elements. It will copy the same reference here, so it contains 001, 002, and 003. This address will be something different like this, 0002, okay? So now that is nothing but here this, okay, is contains the reference to this and this contains the reference to this and this contains the reference to this, okay? So now when I add a new value to list 1 or list 2, okay, for example, if I'm appending a new value called 5, okay, so then object is created 5 and that reference will be stored here. If it is 004, okay, it will be stored here. Because list 2 and list 1 IDs are different, it won't alter the list 1, okay? So we'll get two different lists. But when I try to do changes here, okay, so for this value, okay, so if I try to change list 2 of 0 of 1, so that is nothing but here list 2, it contains the reference of this and in that 1th index value is this, okay? So now if I try to alter this, what will happen is, okay, take example, I am changing it to A, okay? So new object is created A and if its reference is something like 03, okay? So here, this will be overwritten. It contains reference 03 now, okay? So this will be deleted, okay? Now it contains this value now because it is altered now, okay? But here we can see both this list, okay, contains this same reference, that is 001, and we did changes here, okay, so that's why it will affect both. That's why we can see the changes in both the list, okay. So because 001, we can see both list contain that reference. So when I do changes here, okay, so that will affect both the list. That's why the shallow copy behaves differently in the nested list, okay. So when we don't want this, then we can use deep copy. And to know about the deep copy, you need to watch the next tutorial. So that's it for now, guys. Today we discussed about how actually shallow copy works. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.